Donny.
You okay there, sweetheart?
Look a little flustered.
I'm fine. I just didn't have time for breakfast and the garage was full. Oh, and that's right. My boyfriend can't sleep through a thunderstorm without his teddy bear.
I don't understand why you keep putting up with him.
Yeah. I mean, the guy's 35 and he's working for a rental car service.
No, you guys, it's not about that. I don't care about that. I mean, I'd love him if he was a janitor. I mean, he has a huge heart and we laugh a lot. It's just a bonus that he's like the hottest guy in Boston. I don't know, I just wish he would get his life together. Our life, and he can't, and I swear to God, it is because of that bear.
You should give him an ultimatum. It's you or the bear.
No, I can't do that. That would devastate him. Besides, what if he chose Ted?
Well, hello there. Sorry if I'm interrupting any private girl talk about Channing Tatum's index finger, but Lori, I need to see you in my office.
Yeah, the thing is, Rex, I have a lot of work I need to get to.
No, this is work, I swear.
Look,
thank you.
He's such an asshole.
Out of control. He's such a sleaze.
$100 says he's showing her the diving team photo.
Check this out.
That's me on the high school diving team. We dove the shit out of that pool that year.
Now, if you look close, you can see the outline of my route.
You promised me this was about work.
Lori, why don't you like me? I'm rich, I'm good looking, my dad owns the company.
I have a boyfriend. I've told you this.
Yeah, the guy with the bear. But I'm talking about a mature relationship, Lori. I mean, if we were together, our babies would be spectacular. I mean, with my top of the pyramid Caucasian genes and your splash of dark, beautiful, smoky Baltic, check.
Goodbye, Rex.
Okay.
Okay, that was perfect.
Would you like me to wrap your leftovers?
No, I'm good. Thank you.
Actually, could you wrap just this up for me? I want to scare the shit out of somebody.
Sure. What are you, like 5 years old?
Yeah, but I read at a 6-year-old level, so.
Sir and madam, here is your dessert and champagne.
Ooh, Cristal.
It's a special night. We've been dating for 4 years. And hey, all those rich black people can't be wrong, right?
Oh, doesn't feel like 4 years, does it?
No, it doesn't.
You know, you had no business being out on that dance floor. But I'm really happy that you were.
This song is so great.
Oh yeah, Chris Brown can do no wrong.
Wow, you can really move.
You like that, huh? Check this shit out. Oh my God. Are you okay? Oh God, I am so sorry.
No, I'm fine.
Jesus, I am so sorry. I didn't see you. It was an accident. Did you hurt your head?
Yeah, my head hurts a lot.
Oh man, here, let me get you some ice. Sorry. Does it hurt?
No, it's fine.
Okay, here's a test to see how much you actually care about me. You remember that night after the club we went and had late night eggs and waffles till about 5 a.m.? We watched a movie on the little TV in the diner. Name that movie.
Octopussy.
Baby, gold star.
And by the way, my dancing was not that bad.
It was pretty bad.
I have cool moves.
Yeah, so do people with Parkinson's.
That's not how I remember it.
Okay, how do you remember it? Whatever you say.
Hey.
Yes.
Here's to 4 more years, huh?
Okay.
You make me happy. Now, I know we said no gifts, but...
We said no such thing.
I got you something anyway, in clear violation of the no gift rule.
We had no such rule.
Ari, I wanted to give this to you for a long time.
John.
Those are the ones you like, right? From that kiosk at the mall?
Yeah.
You know, Laurie, someday there's gonna be a ring in there, right? But I wanna wait until I get you something really special, you know? I just don't have the money right now.
Look, I'm only saying this because I love you. You're not gonna have any sort of career if you keep wasting time with Ted.
Oh, geez, here we go.
Baby, please ask Ted to move out so we can move on with our lives.
Laurie, look, he's been my best friend since I was 8. I was not a popular child. You have to understand, I had no friends before he came along. He's the only reason I ever gained any fucking confidence. I could have wound up like that Asian kid at Virginia Tech, but I didn't because of him. So, you know, I'm not that psyched to just, like, kick him out.
Well, it's good to know that a talking teddy bear is the only thing that prevented you from gunning down your classmates. But you're no longer 8. You're 35 years old. And unless you're too blind to notice, he's not your only friend anymore.
Can we talk about this another time and just enjoy our anniversary dinner?